Variable number of arguments using the params keyword have been a part of C# since its inception. This function calculates the maximum among many numbers. You can call it with any number of arguments and it will process them readily. Is this not wonderful? Yeah, sure it is, especially if you prefer to put issues under the rug. It must be great then. The params keyword allows for an empty array. That is a serious issue. And a similar problem arises when you already have the data, but they are stored in an inconvenient collection. We must pay the cost of repackaging the data into an array. Alright, welcome to the video where we will address these issues like real programmers. Two things will help. One is to learn to use params properly. This was a bad design from the outset. The other thing is to learn when and how to use params collections, which are supported beginning with C# 13. First things first, how is this function allowing a call with no arguments when it requires at least one number? A traditional approach might be to throw on invalid input. Generations of programmers have grown up on this theory, which I find deeply flawed. I mean, this call will still cause an exception. Someone writing that function below might say, "Oh, it's not my fault," but that won't make me happy. What is there to be happy about the piece of code that just failed? If you are the one to design a function with params, and you know the function should not accept zero elements, then put one element ahead. I am replacing a defensive design with a design that doesn't require defense. It is a much better option if you can avoid the need to defend altogether. The numbers that follow are not the numbers anymore, they are just other numbers. There's nothing to defend from anymore. A caller would be perfectly right to call the function with no additional numbers. The first number is sufficient to initialize the result. The others are there to compete with it for the title. This design no longer qualifies as bad. It is better than it used to be in the sense that invalid calls are now impossible to make. A call that used to cause an exception now fails to compile. I must fix my code, for example, by fetching a substitute when no other values are available or skipping the call altogether. No excuses! Another benefit is that a good design will click with other existing designs. No need to reinvent the wheel. People have been doing this kind of loop since the dawn of computers. Use the existing solutions. While this is not a hard and fast rule, you will start to notice the regularity. Any good design you create will tend to fit well with other good designs. Conversely, if an obvious shortcut is available, that alone is confirmation that you did something well. More good things will happen after this success. The design will spill over to the caller in the most positive way. Imagine there is a UI application. It would need to include a separate control to input the first element, as well as additional controls to input more items optionally. The entire application would be free from exceptions. There won't be any corner cases to test. But that is only one possibility where we are free to create an efficient solution that is also safe by design. The other possibility is that we really have an array on the calling side. There are two challenges in this situation. One is the validation. Someone must ensure that the array is acceptable. The function below still allows an empty array but requires an explicit first item. The caller would need to sanitize its data. But then the real trouble comes with calling the function. The caller would need to separate the first element from the others while still passing the others as an array. The syntax is short, but the execution is lengthy. It would include constructing an auxiliary array and copying all elements past the first one into it. The performance penalty is obvious. In a program where this call occurs frequently, we might not be able to justify the safe design with params. Don't despair. C# 13 brought a long-awaited improvement to the params. Over the course of 2 decades, these were officially called parameter arrays. The official documentation has changed. Now it calls this a parameter collection. It can be many things. We will come to a list of constraints, but first, let me provide you with a motivational example. Most outrageously, it can be a sequence, an enumerable. That could be any collection, or no collection at all. Look here. I am skipping the first element of the array and passing the rest of it in the form of a lazily evaluated sequence. This is not what happens anymore. There is no memory-to-memory copying involved anymore. All overhead boils down to having an explicit enumerator, which might eventually cause a somewhat slower iteration. On the other hand, this is more of a corner case. And I like the range syntax. We are one step back with this, as this call will once again create an auxiliary array. Can we do better? Yes, we can. If you want both speed and flexibility, then another option at your disposal is to receive a params span or a read-only span. You won't be able to use a link with spans. Spans are built for speed as well as for avoiding unnecessary memory-to-memory copying. Revert to good old looping and do the job yourself. You should be more than happy to learn that the range expression at the calling site will make no allocations and will copy nothing from the original array. C# 13 has finally made params fast while retaining all the flexibility they had already. Calling the function with a fixed list of arguments will still create an array for the params argument. There is no other way. But that raises an interesting question. What other collections can we use with params? Before we unveil that mystery, let me steal a moment of your time to mention the sponsors of my channel. This channel is free thanks to the growing community of followers on my Patreon page. If you enjoyed watching this video so far, please consider joining me on Patreon and becoming a sponsor. Besides helping hundreds of fellow programmers watch all the content on my channel for free, every patron also has access to the source code accompanying all the videos on the channel. You will find the links in the description. Now comes the central question. If I had a list with data, could I still invoke a method with params? This situation is at least equally as common as that with the array. Right now, I cannot pass that list as the argument because there is no implicit conversion to a read-only span. But unlike with earlier versions of C#, the function can now accept the params list. That will ruin the examples above, which are both based on arrays. But notably, the attempt with the literal arguments will still compile fine. Let me do that again here. The difference is that the compiler will now collect the values past the first one into a list and then pass that list into the function. Understanding how that works will teach you everything about parameter collections. There are two conditions you must satisfy when accepting a concrete collection type as a parameter collection. One is that there is a parameterless constructor. The other is that there is an add method which receives a single collection element. These conditions are perfectly reasonable. The compiler will translate a literal list of arguments into a portion of code similar to this. It will utilize the parameterless constructor and the add method to accomplish the task. The creators of C# went even further than this. They also let us use interfaces. You saw me use enumerable. Any collection will satisfy it. I have passed lists and arrays uniformly in this demo. The compiler will handle a literal list of arguments by constructing a convenient collection of its own choice. The compiler will behave the same in other cases, such as with iCollection, iList, or iReadOnly list. All these interfaces now work well with the params keyword. Notably, arrays also implement the iReadOnly list interface, and so my entire demo compiles again. That's it. After completing this lesson, you now have a PhD in using params in the latest version of C#.